Hello dear learners and students, it's a wonderful day to learn. Right now I'll be giving a lecture of design of RCC circular water tank resting on ground. There are three types of water tank, that is a tank which is built below the ground, and second case is a tank which is built on the surface of the ground, and third type is a elevated water tank. Right now we are interested in water tank is resting on ground. There are two types of connection between the base of the water tank, that is the slab of the water tank, and the wall. So two types of conditions, mainly rigid and flexible. Right now we will be discussing rigid water tank. Yes, here we have a design condition. This will be a cylindrical water tank of capacity 7 lakh liters is resting on ground. The second condition is given. First one is a cylindrical water tank, that is a circular in plan, and it is resting on ground. The second point is given, that is resting on a good unyielding ground. Some ground might be sinking due to the load. So if the bearing capacity of the ground is low, for example for soft clay, black cotton soil and high organic content soil, you will be having a settlement which is higher than the stiff clay. The depth of the tank is limited to 5 meters, so the height limitation is given, and a freeboard of 300 mm may be provided. And the next case, the wall and the base slab are cast integrally. What do you mean by integrally is, this is rigid. Rigid in the sense, it is called as, in structural analysis, it is fixed. So the wall and the slab is fixed. Okay. Design the tank using M30 grade concrete and Fe415 grade steel. This is the grade of the material which we are going to use. Now what we have to do is, we have to draw the cross section through the center of the tank and showing the reinforcement detail along with its dimensions. So let us have the dimension of the tank initially. So what are all the preliminary data we have is 7 lakh liters and 5 meter height. So the total height will be 5 meters, and they have given a freeboard. You will not have water, you will be having air pressure, and this is given as 0.3. so the remaining height of water will be 4.7 meters. So this is the height for the design which we have considered. Right now what you have to do is, you have to find the thickness and diameter of the tank. So let us find the thickness first. So capital H, that is overall height is 5 meter, which is given here, and 0.3 of freeboard, we will be getting 4.7 meter. So the volume is 700 meter cube. If you need water in terms of meter cube, per meter cube you will be having 1000 liters. So that is why you can divide it by 1000, you will be getting in terms of meter cube. So the total volume is 700 meter cube. If you want the area of the tank, you will be having a volume. If you divide volume by height, you will be getting the cross section. So 700 divided by 4.7, you will be getting the area of the water tank. By that area you can find the diameter of the water tank. So the area of a circle is pi d square divided by 4. So if you do this, you will be getting the diameter. So 13.77, let us round off and design the diameter of the tank is 14 meter. So if you provide 14 meter spacing for holding a water in a tank, then it is sufficient to handle 700 meter cube of water. Next thing is thickness. So what should be the wall thickness? You are having a thumb rule, that is 30H plus 50. So here 30 and 50 are a constant. So H you have to substitute in terms of meter. Always H here in this thumb rule considered as meter, and the value which you are be getting should be written in mm. Yes, right now 30, height is 4.7. So if you multiply that, we will be getting 191 mm after adding. So hence we can assume it as 200 mm of thickness. So in this design process, initially we have found that we need a thickness of 200 mm of wall and the diameter of the tank is being designed. So let us go for the reinforcement of design. Before for going reinforcement, you have to find the forces. What are all the forces which are acting in the water tank? I would like to highlight that in the current revision of water tank, that is in IS 3370 part 1, which is revised at 2009, here for a reinforced concrete section, minimum 320 kg per meter cube of cement is required and maximum water cement ratio is also given. Note here that the minimum grade of concrete should be used for reinforcement cement concrete water tank is M30. So after the revision, the code suggests that minimum M30 grade of concrete is essential. You can also refer this notes for up to, for below 50 m cube of concrete. If it is difficult to go for M30 grade, you can go for M25 grade. However, in coastal areas, definitely you have to take M30 grade of concrete. So depending upon the severity of the environment, you can take the grade of the concrete. The code suggests here that M30 is essential for reinforced concrete. If you are going for plain concrete water tank, you can start with M20. And for pre-stressed concrete water tank, you have to start from M40 grade of concrete. So this is what I would like to highlight during this design. Yes, whenever you are designing, first you will find the dimension and next you will analyze. So what are the types of forces which is acting in the tank? So right now I have the plan of the tank. So we have identified the diameter of the tank is 14 meter. You will be having a water inside the tank. So what will happen? The water will provide pressure in the circumference of the tank. So the inner side of the tank will be having the water pressure, which will be acting equally in all the sides. So this is a water pressure. So due to this water pressure, what happens? There is a stress which is created. The walls are being tensioned. This wall tends to extend. So both the part will get tensioned. So that is why if I cut here, I will be having a, if the water pressure which is acting inside, what happens? The material gets tensioned. So this tension is called tension. So the stress here which is created is a hoop stress, and the tension here is hoop tension. So right now we have to find the hoop tension. How to find this? We very well know that the thickness of the wall is 200 mm. So to find the hoop stress, what you have to do is you can refer IS 3370 part 4. So in this part you are having a coefficient which you can use, and the formula which is given there. So you can see here that the table 9, which in IS 3370 part 4, you can have the values of hoop tension. This condition is for tension in circular ring wall and fixed base. Note here that for right now we are designing a circular water tank for fixed base and free at the top. So at the top part of the water tank you are not providing any roof, so it is open and it is subjected to triangular load. Triangular load in the sense the water will be having a pressure similar to a triangle. The top part of the wall will be having zero pressure and the bottom of the wall will be having a high pressure. So for this condition they have given the coefficient at each and every point. So the total height is taken as h and the diameter is given as d, the radius is r, so thickness is assumed as t. So what is the formula which is given to find this tension is coefficient into WHR. We know that h is the height of the wall. So what is the height of the wall? We have found that 4.7 and the diameter we have found is 14 meter and the radius will be 7 meter. So we know that h and r, also w is the density of the liquid. So we are using water, so the density of the liquid here is 10 kilonewton per meter cube. Only thing what we have to find is the coefficient. So how to find the coefficient? First you have to find h square by dt. What is h square by dt? Let us go here. H is the height of the water which is filled. So 4.7 square, d is the diameter, that is 14, and t is the thickness of the wall. Everything is substituted here. Here you got 7.89, that is nearly 8. So h square by dt, right now our value is 8. For 8, you can see that in the row wise, the place where you have highest coefficient, the highest coefficient here is, this is minus 0.001. If you keep on searching here, you can find the highest value of hoop tension is at the height of 0.6 into overall height. So our overall height is 4.7. So 4.7 into 0.6. At this place, you are having a highest point of hoop force. So and you can see the force is gradually reduced. So at the bottom, that is 0H, at the bottom you will be having a lesser hoop tension. And if you keep on adding the height at 0.9H, you will be having a force of 0.151, this coefficient into this value. So let us take the critical point, that is 0.575. And let us proceed with the problem. So 0.575, if you multiply the density of the water, that is 10 kilonewton per meter cube, and height into the radius, if you multiply this, you got the tension, that is maximum tension, as 189.175 kilonewton. So this is the force which is acting in the circular water tank. So throughout the height you will be having different value. Right now we are interested in the maximum force. Yes, okay. What is the second type of force? Is bending moment. So for finding bending moment, you are having a separate table, that is table 10 of IS 3370 part 4. If we look into that, yes, right now we are landed in table 10. Here it is moments in a cylindrical wall for fixed base, free top and subjected to triangular load. So this is our condition for finding bending moment. Always if you are having any force which is acting at the top, bottom the structure is fixed, you are having a triangular load in this structure. So this is similar to a cantilever beam which is fixed at its bottom and you are having a triangular force. So how to find the bending moment at the bottom? So you are having a coefficient here in order to easily find out the bending moment. So right now we have to find the coefficient. We know that h square by dt is 8. So let us search the highest value of coefficient. So if you look into this, you will be having a highest coefficient at 1 into height. So this is 0.0146, which is in terms of negative. So this is our highest coefficient. Let us take that and substitute here. And here the formula is w into h cube. So what do you mean by h cube is height, that is 4.75 cube into this 10. If you multiply that, that is, we have not considered the sine. I will explain it why. So this coefficient into 10 into 4.7 cube, you will be getting 15.15 kilonewton meter. So this will be the maximum moment. So after finding the moment, so right now why we are not considering the negative sign is, we are going to provide the reinforcement at the, see in note 2 they have given positive sign indicates tension on outside. So if we have negative value, the thing is the tension is acting inner side. So the inner side of the wall, so this is outer and inner side of the wall. So inner side of the wall which is having the tension. So that is why it is indicated here as negative. Okay. So let us now design. Also, I would like to highlight here that IS 3370 suggests that you can design the water tank by using working stress method or limit state method. Code provides guidelines for both. So let us start from the basic. Let us now design with the working stress method. In future, I will provide a separate lecture for designing of water tank by using a limit state method. Okay. So for designing a structure by using working stress method, IS 3370 part 2 has the design guideline. So in that part 2, you can use that in order to design for working stress. Also, you can parallelly get help from the IS 456. For these are the design values which you can take in the code book. For M30 grade concrete, sigma CBC, that is stress, sigma stress in concrete due to bending, and the bending might be compression and tension. So this is compression, that is CBC, that is concrete bending compression. So the value here is 10, so which you have to take in the code book. So I will refer here. So this is IS 456 2000. For working stress design, you can see that for M30 grade concrete which we are now designing, code suggests that sigma CBC, that is concrete in bending compression, the value can be taken as 10 Newton per mm square. And this value you have to use when you are considering direct compression. Okay. So also for finding modular ratio M, you are having a formula, that is 280 divided by 3 into sigma CBC. If you want to find M, you have to substitute 10 here and you can find the M for our design. Also, I would like to highlight that in IS 3370 part 2, this same guideline which is being given for permissible stress in concrete. So the table 2 in IS 3370 part 2 gives for M30 grade you can use 10 Newton per mm square, which is similar to IS 456. Okay, so let us take into account. And also for permissible stress in steel, so this is for concrete, how much force which is permissible, it is given up to 10 you can go. So for steel, they have given it as, right now we are using HYST bars, so that is why we can take 130 Newton per mm square. So this is for tension. And if a force in a structure which is compressive, then you can take, if you are using HYST bar, you can take 140. So this is for plain rounded bar. Right now we are using HYSD and we will be going with 130 Newton per mm square for steel. Okay, so we have taken this two value from the code book and let us proceed the design. So for M30 sigma CBC is 10 and sigma ST is 130, and M, how to find that? You have to substitute 280 divided by 3 into sigma CBC, that is 10. If you substitute that, you will be getting 9.33 for M30 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. Okay, so there are three constant which has to be found out in order to proceed the design. So that is, the constant are K, J and Q. For finding this constant, you are having three different formulas. Let us look into first formula. If you want to find K constant, M into sigma CBC, M into sigma CBC plus sigma ST. Right now you know that this is 9.33 and 10 divided by 9.33 into 10 plus 130. If you substitute here and solve this, you will be getting 0.42. This is a constant. And if you want to find J, 1 minus K by 3. So K here is 0.42 divided by 3. So if you solve here, you will be getting 0.861. And finally for Q, half into sigma CBC into J into K. Right now you know J and K, multiply with sigma CBC, that is 10 into 0.5. So you will be getting 1.80. So these are the design constant you have to find. After finding this, the formula here is to find effective depth by using working stress method. You can root of, you can find the root of M by Q B. So M here is moment. So the moment what we got earlier is 15.15 kilonewton meter. We are substituting here in Newton mm, so hence we are multiplying into 10 power 6, and Q what we got here is 1.8 into B. So for 1 meter width we are considering, if you multiply it into 1000, you will be getting a effective depth required is 92 mm. So what thickness we have given for this slab is, we have given 200 mm, so the effective depth will be higher what we have considered earlier. Yes, so the overall thickness we have considered is 200 mm, and if we provide a cover of 33 mm, that is effective cover, the depth provided is 167 mm. It is far greater than the required. So required here nearly around 90, we have provided 167, hence it is safe. In order to find AST, you have to substitute M by sigma ST JD. You know the moment, that is 15.15 into 10 power 6. Sigma ST is 130 into J, we found already 0.861 into effective depth, that is 167. If you substitute, you will be getting a area of steel of 810.5 mm². So for this reinforcement, let us assume 16 mm diameter bar. So for finding spacing, this is the area of the steel, that is pi into 16 square divided by 4 into 1000. This is per meter. You have to multiply the 1000 divided by AST required, that is 810.5. If you solve this, you will be getting 247.9 mm. Center to center is required. Right now we are assuming 200 mm center to center. We will be providing 16 mm dia bar at 200 mm center to center as vertical reinforcement on the wall face. Note here that this reinforcement will be provided in vertical face. Why? Because the bending moment is along the vertical plane, hence we are providing vertical reinforcement. For horizontal reinforcement, we have to use hoop tension. So that we will be using the tension. So the force here is axial. So for an axial force, for axial stress, you have to use the formula force by area. Here the force is the hoop force, that is hoop tension. We got an answer of 189.275 in kilonewton. If you substitute in terms of newton into 10 power 3, we will be multiplying. Divided by sigma st is 130. So if you divide this, you will be getting 1455.9 mm square of AST required. So we will be providing 16 mm dia bar. If you are providing 16 mm dia, you can find the spacing. So after solving this, you are getting 138 mm center to center is required. For this, you can assume a round off value of 16 mm dia bar at 130 mm center to center as hoop reinforcement on the wall face. So this will be horizontal reinforcement. Whenever you find bending moment, you can find the bending moment value and the reinforcement in vertical plane. Hoop tension will be provided for horizontal plane in case of water tank. Yes, let us now check for tensile stress. So you are having a formula in this code book, that is sigma c, that is stress which is acting in concrete. So the concrete has inbuilt tension carrying capacity. If the concrete stress exceeds due to the hoop force, what happens? The crack arises. In order to reduce the crack, so for that let us provide T is hoop tension, the value is written here, divided by, this is area. What is this? This is area of concrete, that is 1000. We will be considering breadth as 1000 and thickness, as we know that we have provided thickness of wall as 200. So plus m minus 1. So m, we know that modular ratio is 9.33 minus 1 into AST. AST we have provided is 1546. So you can check that area required is 1455.9 mm square. So after providing a reduced spacing, you will be getting an actual area steel provided is, for 130 mm spacing, you will be getting 1546. So if you substitute here with this value, you will be getting stress in concrete will be 0.89, which is tensile stress. So this is the tensile stress acting in the concrete in the water tank. So let us check for the inbuilt tensile load carrying capacity of the tank. So the formula here is 0.27 root of FCK. So here FCK is 30, that is permissible compressive stress of concrete. So if you substitute this, you will be getting 2.84 newton per mm square of tensile strength which is available in the concrete. So hence this is greater than 0.89, hence the structure will be not having any cracks in our water tank. Okay, so I'll be mentioning here the minimum reinforcement condition. So for distribution of steel, the code suggests that is 3370 part 2 in class 8.1, the minimum reinforcement essential here is 0.24% of cross section when you are using deformed bar and the dimension is not more than 15 meter. Here our dimension is lesser than 15 meter, hence you can use 0.24% of reinforcement. For general RCC structure, IS 456 suggests 0.12% of cross section. If you are designing water tank, the code suggests that 0.24% when you are using HYSD or deformed bars, you can use this range. So 0.24 divided by 100 into, we will be considering 1 meter width into the thickness of wall. So you will be getting minimum reinforcement of 80 mm square. Okay, for this AST, let us provide 8 mm dia bar. So after finding a spacing, you need 104.7. Hence, we can round off as 8 mm dia bar at 100 mm center to center in vertical and horizontal distribution on outer face. Note that this is outer face. What you have already found the reinforcement earlier in the tank will be inner face. Why? Because the value of coefficient which is negative, hence we are providing the reinforcement in inner face. Okay, the spacing of the bar nowhere should not generally go beyond 300 mm or thickness of the section. So that is why whenever you are providing spacing, you can check for the guideline here. So nowhere it is beyond 300 mm or the thickness of the section. Okay. Last, we are having a base lab. So we have designed the wall, that is inner and outer reinforcement we have provided. Right now we are designing the base lab of the tank. So for designing that, let us assume 150 mm thickness of the slab and proceed. So we can go for minimum reinforcement, that is 0.24 into 1000, that is breadth into the thickness. If you multiply, you will be getting 360. And reinforcement for each face, we can divide the reinforcement at the bottom of the slab and top of the slab. If we are dividing into two face, what we can do is we can divide it by two, and if we are using 8 mm dia bar, that is the area of the bar will be pi into 8 square divided by 4, that is 50.24 divided by 180. So the spacing here is, which is required, is 279.0 mm. Earlier I suggest that the code also guides that not beyond the thickness of the section. Here the thickness of the section is 150 we have assumed. So we can take 150 mm center to center as minimum spacing in vertical and horizontal distribution of outer face. So this reinforcement we will be providing at both the faces. Yes, this is the final design of the section. Right now we are having the cross section. First we have designed the thickness of the wall of 200 mm and we had a freeboard of 0.3. Okay, then we designed the inner side wall. The inner wall which you have designed is for circumferential steel, that is for hoop stress, you have provided the horizontal bars, which is 16 mm dia at 130 center to center. And see, the hoop stress will be higher at one particular part. At the extreme side, you can increase the spacing up to 200 mm center to center. This is the maximum size we can increase for the design. Okay. Then for the vertical reinforcement, we have considered bending moment, and by using the bending moment, we found that the reinforcement which is required is 16 mm dia bar at 200 mm center to center, which is the inner vertical face. For the outer vertical face, we provided a minimum reinforcement, that is 8 mm dia bar at 100 mm center to center, both the vertical and horizontal. So this is what the design. And for the base of the water tank, we have provided a overall thickness of 150 for both vertical and horizontal. In the both the face, we have provided 8 mm dia bar at 150 mm center to center. So this is our design. Always you will be having a PCC layer below that. Before laying any concrete section, you will be having a PCC layer. We have considered 80 mm of PCC depth and a projection which is essential beyond the wall. For stability consideration, we have provided 300 mm and the thickness is also raised in this part, that is 230 mm. Okay. So I hope that you would have gained knowledge regarding the design of circular water tank. It is also a picture here which is mentioned. See, the stresses are maximum at the bottom face, the bending force which is higher at the bottom space, and it is decreasing throughout the height. So that is why the reinforcement, for economic reason, we can reduce the reinforcement at the place where you are having a limited stresses. With this, I hope that You will be gaining some knowledge of how to design a circular water tank which is fixed at the base. So there is a slight deviation when you will be designing for a flexible base. So this is a rigid base. For flexible base, there will be a slight modification. The same process will be provided for flexible base. Okay. Happy learning. See you again. Thank you.